kramervegan.net, and today we're going to make Nanaimo bars, which are a Canadian delicacy from Canada. Canadian. They're in my new book, Vegan A Go-Go. Nanaimo bars were originated in the 1950s from Nanaimo, BC, which is on Vancouver Island, which is where I live. And it's a bit of a decadent recipe. It's quite delicious. I actually veganized this recipe from a 1950s cookbook that I had at home. It had a lot of eggs in it, so it was actually pretty easy to veganize. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with the base of the Nanaimo bar. There's actually three layers of yumminess, but right now we're going to start with the base. So what we're going to do is melt a little bit of vegan margarine together with some cocoa powder and some sugar. Just throw that in here. And you don't want, we're not really cooking it, we're just sort of melting it together. But you do want to keep an eye on it, you don't want it to burn. Okay, so you want to stir this constantly. You want to make sure that the heat is quite low, but you want it to be warm enough where you're melting the chocolate and the sugar together. And so that's about the right consistency. What we're going to do is we're going to just put it aside so it's not too hot. We're going to just let it sit for a couple minutes while I mix the other ingredients. So we're going to just let this sit for a couple minutes while we mix the other ingredients together. We don't want to burn my hands. So we're going to throw in some ground, what are these called? Graham crackers! We're going to put in some ground graham crackers. If you can't find vegan graham crackers, you can make your own. There's a recipe, I think, in the Garden of Vegan. Maybe it's How It All Began. It could be La Dolce Vegan. It's in one of these three. Or you can go to the grocery store. You can use any sort of tea biscuits or like these kids cookies from Trader Joe's, if you have a Trader Joe's in your area. Any sort of hard biscuit will work, but graham crackers work well too. So we'll throw that in there with a little bit of coconut. Oh, here we go. And some walnuts, which are really important. And then today we're going to use an egg replacer. I wouldn't suggest you use any other egg replacer than flax seeds for this one. Flax seeds, they're just so good at holding things together. So we have 2 tablespoons of ground flax seeds and 3 tablespoons of water. And then we just quickly mix that together. And now we're going to add the chocolate sauce. So we'll just scoop that in there. You want to get all of this out, so use a spatula so you can make sure you get every last drop. And then we're going to just mix this together. This is going to be the base of our Nanaimo bar. So the great thing about Nanaimo bars too is that you don't have to bake them. It's a dessert that you make and then you chill and then you cut and you serve. It's pretty easy. There are some dishes that you have to do, but that's okay. That's what husbands are for. Or dishwashers. So we're going to put this into an ungreased 8x8 pan. And then you got to get dirty. I like to use my knuckles, because what you want to do is you want to push it down so that it's fairly firm. And even. And that's the base for your Nanaimo bar. Now we'll move on. You're making me laugh. So what we're going to do now is we're going to make the top layer, and then we're going to make the middle layer. The top layer consists of 4 squares of unsweetened chocolate. And we're going to actually use the same pot because I don't like to do dishes. So we have 4 squares of unsweetened chocolate. And you want to cook it. You can use a double boiler if you want to get fancy, but come on. That's another dish you have to wash. And then we have a couple tablespoons of vegan margarine. And oh, this is the cutest little spatula ever. So you want to keep an eye on it while it melts, but you don't have to stir it like you did the last one, because the last one had sugar, so you wanted to make sure it didn't burn. But we can just leave that while we work on the center. So in the original Nanaimo bar recipe, the center traditionally is yellow, and that's because of custard. We're not using custard. What we're going to use is vegan margarine and some vegan icing sugar or powdered sugar. What do you guys call it here in the States? I don't know. Anyway, I call it icing sugar. I know it's different from depending on where you live. And then we have a little bit of milk. You can use soy milk or rice milk or hemp milk. A little bit of vanilla, about a teaspoon and a bit. And then we're going to put in cornstarch. And then in order to make this the authentic yellow color, we're going to put in just a little bit of turmeric. I think it's a quarter teaspoon. If your turmeric is quite strong, then you might want to lower the dosage because you don't want it to taste like turmeric. But if you're just putting in a little bit for color, then you're not going to taste it. Whoops. Let's make sure. And the cornstarch is in there to help it thicken everything up. Help me. There we go. And then we're going to just pulse this until it becomes mixed. Pretty good. So it's not super yellow right now, but it'll actually get a little bit more yellow as it sits. And what we're going to do is, let me just move this out of the way. We have our bottom layer. So now we'll just spread this evenly on the bottom layer. Oh my lord. My mouth is watering already. This is not good. Okay, so we want this spread evenly on the bottom. And actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to tuck this in the fridge until the top layer is ready. Because there's margarine in here, we don't want it to get too soft. Because when we pour the chocolate sauce on top, that's quite warm. And so we don't want it to melt. We want there to be three distinct layers. So I'll toss this in the fridge and then we'll check the sauce. So the sauce is nice and melted. It's still warm, but we don't want it to be really hot because the second layer is made out of margarine, so we don't want everything to melt. So I'm going to get the Nanaimo bars out of the fridge. So this is really quick. You want to do this really quick. You want to pour the top on top. And again, we don't want everything to melt together. So you got to be quick, quick, quick. So what I like to do is just roll it around so it's nice and even. And then we're going to pop this in the fridge, and you want to chill it for at least an hour. And lucky for you, I have one already chilling. Oh my lord, look at that. So we're going to chop these up into little squares. You can do big squares, but man, this is a seriously rich dessert, so I suggest tiny squares. Unless you're my husband, then you just eat it with a fork. Let me see if I can get this out of here in one piece. Oh, oh shoot, I left the bottom. Okay, so the first one I cut, it kind of fell apart. I think actually maybe this is a little too cold to cut into squares because you can see that it's cracking. So maybe what we'll do is we'll just let it sit for a few before we cut it up. But look at this. So we got the crunchy walnutty layer, and then we have the yellowy sweet layer, and then we have the bitter chocolate layer. It's to die for. Oh, oh, I'm going to get in trouble if I eat all this. It's delicious. I'm Sarah. This is the everyday... What is it?
Everyday dish.
This is Everyday Dish.TV.